Welcome again. I'm Dr. James Patterson, professor of English. I teach English composition classes, and this is number 7, lesson number 7 in a short series on academic writing, specifically writing research papers for your junior and senior years at the university. In this particular video, I want to show you how to incorporate your research materials into your essay, your paper. You'll recall from an earlier video that one of the definitions of a research paper is an expanded essay. And so the professor wants the paper that you submit, the professor wants you and your voice to be the dominant voice in the paper. Now I'm going to talk about in-text references using the signal phrase or what we may call an introductory phrase. I'm also going to talk about parenthetical citations. Now, the paper that I'm going to show you in my screencast today is in the APA style. So I'll talk a little bit about how it would be different in MLA. I'll also talk about how it might be different in the Chicago Manual style. So we'll cover all three in this video. But I want to talk about citing quoted material, and then I'll talk about citing paraphrased and or summarized material as well. So let's take a look at the screen here in front of me so you can see what I'm talking about. This is in the APA style, and you'll see in the upper left-hand corner of the header, the student has given in all caps the running head or running title for this paper, Time Management in Academic Dishonesty. You'll notice that the page number is in the upper right-hand corner in the header. Now, typically in APA format, page 2 is going to be your abstract. Since I'm an English composition teacher, I let my students forego the abstract because typically my papers are not going to be as long to need an abstract. But when you get to the university for your junior and senior years, check with your professor whether he or she wants an abstract and ask them what they expect in an abstract. In this case, the abstract is missing. The student begins her paper on page 2. She begins with a quote from Baird and Dewey. This is the first time, this is the first paragraph of her paper. So for her first reference to Baird and Dewey, she puts their names in the signal phrase, according to Baird and Dewey. Since this is in APA format, she gives the date of publication in parentheses immediately following the names of the authors. Then she goes directly into her quotation. The quotation marks tell me that she is using the exact words that were written by Baird and Dewey. Quote, plagiarism and other forms of academic misconduct are matters of great concern at all levels of study worldwide. This is especially so for students in a higher education institution. Close quote lets me know that she's stopping her direct quotes from Baird and Dewey, and then in parentheses, she gives me the parenthetical reference that she's taken this information from page 387 of the journal that Baird and Dewey published their article in. This is a very good opening reference to Baird and Dewey. Anywhere else in the paper that the student chooses to use Baird and Dewey, she no longer needs to say according to Baird and Dewey. Anytime in the future, she can go directly into her quoted material or her paraphrased material and put Baird and Dewey 2014 in the parenthetical, and I'll show you that in just a moment. But let's take a look at this next one. She goes right on to Mabrato Mulatu Bakori 2016. Again, the name of the author and the name and the date of publication in parentheses. Notice in the first case she said according to Baird and Dewey. Now she's getting down to business. She goes straight to the author's name and the date of publication. She says that Dr. Bakori surveyed Hawassa University students to understand leading dishonesty acts and causes of academia. In his studies, he discovered. Then quote, the quotation mark tells the reader that she is going to begin using Bakori's words from his article. That's what the quotation mark says. Submitting an assignment that was written by someone else, 90% of his students at the university had done that. Copying material from a published source without giving credit, 72.2% of the students responded that they had done that, and copying from someone else during a test, 67.5% said they had done that in their academic career. Notice that then the student gives a closing quotation mark. She is stopping her quote, her quoted passage from Bokori, and again, she gives us in parentheses pages 18 and 19. And then she comes back to her own words. These three items were the most common cases of academic misconduct, period. So, she has given the name of the author in the signal phrase. She's given the date of publication immediately after the names of the authors. She has given us the quoted material, which is highlighted and set off with quotation marks, and then she has placed in parentheses the page number from which this quoted material was taken. In this case, this is the first time she's talking about Barrett and Dewey, and so she puts their names in the signal phrase. Now, in this next paragraph, she says, why then do students cheat? And again, it's Bokori, 2016. Notice above, she gave the full name of the author. The second reference is just the last name, and again, 2016. And again, she's going to include a quoted material. Quote, 85% of the respondents stated time scarcity as a reason for their academic misconduct. She stops quoting Bokori after the word reason, so she closes the quote with a closing quotation mark. And because there is no signal phrase here, she began the sentence with the 85%. In parentheses, in the parenthetical, she gives us Bokori's name, the date of publication, and the page number from which she has drawn the quote. All right? Now, having said that, I want to ask this question. What goes in the signal phrase? What goes in the parenthetical? All right? To answer that question, we're going to look at her references page. You'll see that Baird and Dewey, 2014, wrote an article entitled Ensuring Effective Student Support in Higher Education Alleged Plagiarism Cases. That article was published in the journal Innovative Higher Education, volume 39.5, and this article appears on pages 387 through 400. The student has not given me a URL to find the paper. She has given me the DOI number, which is preferred because URLs can change, but DOIs do not. So I've got Baird and Dewey. So what goes into the signal phrase? Whatever appears first on your documentation. When she talked about Dr. Bokori, what goes in parentheses? What goes in the signal phrase? Whatever is first in the references document, so that the reader, seeing the reference in text, can go immediately to your bibliography, scan down that left-hand margin, and find the information quickly and easily. So, in-text and parenthetical citations are important because they identify for your reader that you are borrowing material from your research. Quoted passages must be identified with quotation marks. The name of the author and the date of publication in APA simply lets us know that that's where the ideas came from. Quoted materials, when you're borrowing Bokori's words, you have to put Bokori's words in quotation marks. And whatever you put in the text needs to lead immediately to the bibliography and whatever is listed first on the bibliographic entry. Wow, that's a lot of information, but I know you can do it. Take a breath and get to it. Good luck.